Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy. Today's video, I'm going to be just talking and giving some tips that I have found over the years work well for taming your hamster. Now, the thing that I want to stress, first of all, is that I am not an expert and I don't claim to be an expert. I'm just sharing tips that I've found has worked really well for my past hamsters. And then the other thing that I want to mention is that animals have their own free will, and we have to keep that in mind and always respect them. We can't force them to, you know, interact or cuddle or whatever. Like, we can't force them to do that if they don't want to. So to a certain extent, you can tame your hamster and hopefully at least make them feel a little bit more comfortable around you, but it's possible that not all hamsters will be cuddly or want to be held. So I think that we need to keep that in mind and respect their individual little personalities. But anyway, I'll go ahead and get started. I hope you guys find these tips to be useful. So the first tip that I'm going to give is to let your hamster settle in for about 4 to 6 days or so after they come home before you start interacting or taming. I personally like going a week. I find that a week works a little bit better and the hamster's a little bit more relaxed. You have to remember that hamsters have been through a whole lot. They've been transported from place to place, whether it's from a mill to a pet store or from a shelter or whatever it might be. They've been through a lot of stress, so they can be a little bit sort of nervous and jumpy, so that's why it's really good to just give them that week's time and you know, let them settle in. It does require some patience, which I know is hard, especially for first time hamster owners. They want to start playing and interacting, but I promise it'll pay off in the long run if you just are patient and let your hamster have their own personal space for the first week or so. So during the first week, it is really great if you talk to your hamster as often as possible, and that way they can get used to your voice. If they let you, if your hamster is, you know, a little bit more calm or friendly, you can try holding a treat between your fingers and offer it to them. You know, just hold it out and let your hamster come to you. Do not go to them or, you know, keep following them around the cage so that they feel threatened. And if your hamster does take the treat, that's great, but, you know, don't try to do anything else like petting your hamster or anything like that for the first week. Remember, you have to build up trust before you can progress to the next step, okay? So assuming that your hamster is progressing well with those steps, the next step you can try is to take the little piece of food and to place it on your hand. Now, if you are nervous about being bitten, you can try wearing gloves at first, but eventually you will have to take the gloves off because you do want your hamster to get used to your hand. What I usually do is I rub my hand in their bedding, and that way it gets the hamster scent on my hand and it's not such a huge, like, you know, shock that they're like, what is this? And they don't know what it is and they might bite. So I don't know, I've always found that just rubbing my hands on the bedding helps a whole lot. So just put the treat on your hands, see if your hamster will come over and take the treat. You know, if they put their paws on your hand, that's great. Don't freak out or anything. Chances are they're not gonna happily sit on your hand and just be like, oh, I just love this. I mean, very, very rarely does that happen right away. So don't take it as a bad sign, but just remember, little tiny baby steps. So the third step is to basically continue doing this and build up trust by using positive reinforcement and motivation to get your hamster to associate your hand and associate you with good things, whether it's a treat, whether it's taking them out, you know, for playtime, whatever it might be. I know it's really hard if your hamster isn't food motivated. Like, Yodel was not at all food motivated, so I had to do other tricks with him. Like, he enjoyed coming out, so I would use my hand, and he knew when he hopped up on my hand that he was going to be able to get out of the cage and run around. So it's just trying to find, you know, what works best for your hamster, because every hamster's personality is different and food won't work for everyone. So yeah, what you want to do is cup your two hands like this and sort of scoop it underneath your hamster. I personally don't like the claw method, is what I call it, where you like go down from above, because that's like essentially like they're a prey animal outside and they might feel like they're being attacked by a bird or something like that. So don't use the claw method, okay? Use the very gentle cupping method with your hands, and that won't freak them out quite so much.
The most important thing to keep in mind out of this whole video is
to never progress to the next step until your hamster is comfortable with the previous steps. So basically, don't start picking up your hamster until they are fine with taking food from you, until they recognize you and they're comfortable being petted in the cage. Never ever progress to picking them up. I have so many people that message me and say something like, my hamster is jumping out of my hands when I hold them, how do I get them to stop? If your hamster is jumping out of your hands, then they are not comfortable and they're not ready yet. You're going a little bit too fast. So you need to slow down and backtrack, go back to the previous step and get that solidified so that your hamster is relaxed, and that way they won't jump out of your hand when you try to pick them up. So once your hamster finally is on your hands, success, right? Just lift them up a little bit in the cage and, you know, sort of pet them a little bit and put them down shortly after. I don't suggest holding them for long periods of time at first, because some hamsters start to associate going in your hand and being picked up with being confined for an extended period of time, and they don't like that. So make sure that, I like to keep my hands open like this, so that way they don't feel like they're, you know, like closed in, like they can't do anything. But hold it very low. Always sit down with your hamster and hold them only a few inches over the bedding, so that way if your hamster does jump out, they're not going to hurt themselves, okay? As your hamster gets more and more used to being on your hands, you can take them out for longer periods of time. Just build it up very gradually. And then also you can sit in a dry bathtub or sit in a playpen or something like that with them and just let them crawl around on you, and then occasionally you can use the scoop up method that I told you earlier and then put them down and then, you know, scoop them from one place, transport them to another, and it's just really good practice to get them used to sort of being picked up and held. As you progress, you can hold them for longer periods of time if they are comfortable with you. Now, sometimes hamsters don't always progress through these steps and they need a little bit of a nudge. Like Sumatra, which I recently adopted, he was very, very jumpy, and I actually attached some ovo cages onto his large cage, and he was just staying up in the tubes the whole time, so I had to switch to what I call the accelerated program, which basically I had to give him a little bit of a nudge. And I don't suggest forcing your hamster, like I said earlier, but giving them a gentle nudge and encouraging them is really great. So what I did was I actually detached the tubes to that, and I just put him in the large cage below, so that way he wouldn't be able to run up and hide in the tubes when I was trying to interact with him, because we were just not getting anywhere with taming. And sure enough, like 3 days later, after he was in his big cage without the tubes attached, he was coming out more, he wasn't hiding so much, he was getting used to me, and it just really helped. You want to have some hiding places to a certain extent so that your hamster feels comfortable, but you don't want to have so many that they're always hiding and you can never, like, interact with them, so yeah.